Good morning.
Good morning. My name is Abby Leonard, and this is my family, Kyle, Carter, and Cora, and we are excited to welcome you to worship today. Specifically, Bishop Harvey and her husband, Dean. We are so excited for y'all to be here. We are here to welcome all new visitors as well.
Good morning. My name is Kyle Leonard, and I have been a member here at Asbury for almost or around 37 years. To me, Asbury means the world. To me, it is a family. Growing up in youth, I knew where any adult here on campus in our building was always here for me, no matter what. As an adult, I feel very safe with my kids. I know that sometimes they get away and run, and I know everybody here has an eye and is always looking out for everybody here. So I know if given the chance, this could be your home and we could be your family too. For any visitors with us today, in front of you there is a card for first-time visitors, or you could text welcome to 281-305-1068. We also have a welcome desk at the front for any first-time visitors. Stop by, we have a little gift for you. Without further ado, welcome to Asbury. Let's get ready to worship.
Thank you, Leonard family. What a joy to be in the house of the Lord together to worship, to sing praises this morning. I'm going to ask that if you're in the sanctuary and you are willing and able to go ahead and stand with us, we're going to start this morning by singing about how great God's faithfulness is to us, and then we're going to move into some praise. We're going to give him some praise this morning. So will you all join with us?
Oh,
could I keep it inside? I won't be quiet, my God is alive. How could I keep it inside? Oh, praise the Lord, oh, my soul.
Hello, I gotta wait for my wife and my baby. Hello, this is my wife, Hallie, and I'm Jesse, and this is baby Milo, he's sleeping. We're the Hernandez family here. Please join us and remain standing for the affirmation of faith. I believe in God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he should come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You can be seated at this time, and we're going to welcome forward our kids for a very special presentation this morning.
Thank you. If any kids in the sanctuary want to join me up here at the front for the children's message, they can come right up here to the front. You guys did a great job. Thank you for worshiping, serving, and sharing. I think they need another hand. You know, I sang that song when I was y'all's age at church. I still have the sheet music at home, actually. Okay, so this is a big month for Asbury, 80th anniversary, and it's kind of like a big party going on for the whole month of November, right? And today we have Bishop Harvey with us. And before we get started, did you guys know that Bishop Harvey is an alumni from the University of Texas Hook 'em Horns? Yay! Hoorah! All right. Okay, so do you guys even know what a bishop is or what they do? Bishop Harvey has a very big job. She's the bishop for the Texas and Rio, Texas annual conference, and she makes sure that the United Methodist churches from Beaumont to Brownsville to San Antonio to Austin to Houston to Texarkana stay true to our United Methodist faith and mission. She helps churches make disciples of Jesus Christ, and she helps guide the spiritual interests of the church. She serves, she leads, she preaches, and she teaches. And she's also Pastor Lindsay's boss's boss, right? That's a pretty big job that she does. How do you think she does it all? Do you think she does it all on her own? No. Who do you think she goes to for help? I bet she talks to God a lot, right? Because her job is so big. You know, every Christian and disciple of Jesus has a big job to do, even you guys. Bishop Harvey does her job, and you guys can go out and do yours. Asbury sends each of you to share and show the good news of Jesus. You can do this at school, at baseball practice, at dance rehearsals, in your neighborhood, or anywhere, really. You can say it with me if you know it. Worship, grow, serve, and share Jesus with people everywhere you go. You can tell them about how Jesus loves them. You can be kind and helpful. You can invite them to church. And you can show them the joy we feel when we have Jesus in our lives. Now, I have another job for you guys this morning. I'd like for you all to help me say a special blessing over Bishop Harvey. She continues her job. But before we do that, Bishop Harvey, would you come join us up here, please? Before we say a blessing over Bishop Harvey, we want to present her with a special present. Pinky, you want to come up? Last Sunday, for our communion rail offering, we took up collections for the Lydia Patterson Institute in your honor, and Asbury would like to present this to you now. We know this is a special organization dear to you, and it's a total of $704. So thank you, congregation. All right, and now you guys are going to stand and come place a hand out towards Bishop Harvey, and we're going to say a special prayer for her.
Oh, we're going to do like, we're going to stack hands.
Here. That's awesome.
All right, is that all right?
That would be a great picture if you want to come on up, Allie. This is awesome. All right, friends, will you join me in prayer, please? Dear God, we thank you for this day and for our church family. We especially want to say a special blessing over Bishop Harvey as she leads us into the future of making disciples of Jesus, sharing your love and grace with all. Give her strength, patience, and endurance to do your work, and help us go out and share your love as well as we worship, grow, serve, and share Christ. In Jesus' name we pray, and together we all say, amen. Great
amen.
Job,
I
friends.
Think we should do that again. Let's do that. Let's do an amen, like
ready?
A team. Ready? Ready? One, two, three. Amen. All right.
We're going to have WOW worship for kids 3 years old and up to third grade back in the WOW worship room. You want to come with me? Come with me. Bring your paper.
Well, good morning, church. It's so good to be in worship with you today. You know that Veterans Day is coming up, and we would like to take a moment to honor our veterans today. If you are a veteran, would you please stand? Thank you so much for your sacrifice and service for all of us. We're going to stand and greet one another in the love of Christ, and maybe you want to find your way towards a veteran to say thank you to them today. All right, let's go ahead and get back to our seats. Okay, I have a few folks that I would like to ask you to be keeping in your prayers this week. The family of Trish Kellmeyer. Trish goes to our early service and passed away this week. And so we ask for prayers for her son and grandson, both named Max, and for their whole family. We will have a service here in a couple weeks for them, and we'll pass that information along to you when we have it. Also, Kay Shoffit asked for prayers for her daughter, Kristen McKee. You may know that she is fighting brain cancer, and she had a seizure this week, and they asked for special prayers, and hopefully that an MRI can get moved up in the schedule. We also want to ask for prayers for Dennis Humphrey, who had to go back to the hospital this week, and he's at Methodist Clear Lake. And in a moment, Lucan is going to lead us in the Lord's Prayer, but just before that, I'm going to ask that you go ahead and bow your heads and pray with me now. Father God, Jesus Christ, our Savior, Holy Spirit, our friend. Today the sun rose, you impressed us with another beautiful dawn. Patient and kind as you are, you keep the world spinning without us even needing to lift a finger. You bend our worst troubles into somehow bringing good out of them all. You provide all we need and more for abundant living, joyful sharing, and gratitude. You are faithful to us on the mountaintops, and you are faithful in the valleys. You are faithful when we are struck standing still, and when our path is as squiggly as a bowl of spaghetti. You are ever, always, only faithful. And we know that every good and perfect gift rains down from the Father of lights. So we want to take a moment, take this opportunity to take a breath, to acknowledge anything that is on our hearts or our minds this morning, any concerns we have, and then imagine ourselves lifting them up to God and laying them at the foot of his throne. We pray, Lord, that you would help us to leave our cares with you, for you invite us to trade our burdens with you, Lord, and you tell us that yours are light. We ask, God, that you would give a special blessing today for our veterans and their families. We are so grateful for their sacrifice and their service to each of us. We pray, Lord, that you continue to bless them and keep them safe. We pray this morning for our country, for the whole world. And we ask that you would keep our country's leaders safe, that you would give them your protection, your wisdom, and your guidance. We know that through all of the mountaintops and valleys, we will not fear, for you are with us, our cup overflows. So today we choose to be a part of the blessing. We will rejoice with those who are happy and weep with those who are grieving. We'll put on harmony like our favorite sweater. We'll choose to be humble, knowing that there are many times in which we're wrong. We will return evil with good, darkness with light, hate with love. We will follow the upward call to sanctified life and the downward call of the peaceful life. And we pray, Lord, that you would make us peacemakers with one another and the world, that we might find peace with you, Lord. We thank you for all of these things and many more. We thank you for the gifts that are about to be given and ask that you use them for your purposes. And we pray all of this in the name of Jesus, the one who taught us to pray. Say.
Our Lord, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Well done, Lucan. Thank you so much. Now's the time in our service where we give our offerings to the Lord. And in a moment, when the music begins, you could stand, place your gifts in the offering plates by the back doors here, or give in any of these ways online. I was sharing, you might have seen those little Jesuses kind of around. You know that the kids ministry did that recently. And we had the fire department come up here to the church 2 weeks ago for a false fire alarm. And whenever they arrived, they saw those around our church, and they said, "We want some of those." And they, you know, they had been here before because they have their fire department graduations here at our church. And so Miss Paula went and grabbed a few of them and took them to the firehouse this week, and they're putting them up all over the fire station. They're so excited to have them. The reason I share that with you is you never know what God is going to do. You never know what he's going to take and do something else with. And so that is a random and lovely ministry of Asbury that you're a part of whenever you give here at our church. So thank you for the ministry that you're doing.
I'm Our scripture for reading today is Lamentations, chapter 3, verses 22 through 24. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Done, Abigail. Thank you so much. Well, friends, it's such an honor for me to get to introduce you to Bishop Cynthia Fierro Harvey today. She began her ministry here in the Houston area before being asked to run the Center for Missional Excellence for our whole annual conference. And then she was asked to take on, she was the director of UMCOR, if you can believe it or not, for the whole denomination. So you know that she has a missional heart. And then she was elected to be a bishop, and so she served as the Bishop of Louisiana for 8 years before she got to come on home and be our bishop. I'm a little biased, but I think we have the best one in the country. And now, as of this past summer, she is over not only our annual conference, but also the Rio, Texas conference that goes all the way to the border and out to San Antonio and Austin as well. For years, she has been an advisor and a mentor of mine, a confidant and a friend, and I am so happy to be able to introduce you to Bishop Harvey today.
Thank you, Lindsay. And Lindsay, you have been my mentor, my confidant, and my friend as we've traversed this crazy United Methodist Church that we get to serve, so thank you. Thank you all for being here today. We've looked forward to this day for quite a while. Here to celebrate 80 years of ministry and all that God has in store for you for the future. You know, in these last several days, I've been watching on social media that it's homecoming in a lot of places, in a lot of high schools, football season, everybody is celebrating, and I've watched my friends post all kinds of great pictures taking me back down memory lane. My daughter's here with us this morning too. She's in from Dallas for the weekend, so made the trip down here with us as well. But homecoming is just such a great time of celebration, so maybe start to think about kind of our own pep rally today. That's what I'm sort of here to do. You all have been doing great work. So today is kind of a pep rally or a pep talk. And most good schools have a great fight song, right? A great rally song. And we're not going to sing today the Aggie War Hymn. Not because I'm a Longhorn, and we know your pastor is not. We're not going to sing the Aggie War Hymn. We're not going to sing the Eyes of Texas or anything like that. We're going to sing what I have been calling sort of my anthem, my fight song over these last several years. And so I'm going to ask you to, you can stay seated. I'm going to sing the chorus to Great is Thy Faithfulness. You heard it before we started worship today. So I want you to hear it one more time, and I want you to hear the words, particularly when we get to that part of all I have needed, thy hand has provided. I want you to put that in your brain for the morning. So if you could lead us.
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand has provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for that, because it really just sets the tone for what we're going to have a conversation about this morning. Great is Thy Faithfulness has become really one of my favorite hymns. It's an old hymn, but I've been listening to it over and over again, sort of on repeat, with kind of fresh eyes and a new heart to hear these great words. My other sort of anthem or theme song is This Girl is on Fire by Alicia Keys, but it's not very churchy. So we're going to stick to the old hymn. Great is Thy Faithfulness, friends, is what I see and hear and taste and smell the minute I walk into churches like yours and see and encounter and engage with people like you. I don't know if you know this, but that energy that you are, you can taste it, you can smell it, you can feel it 1,000 miles away. The faithfulness of God has sustained you for 80 years. 80 years. And I see and hear of your stories of resilience and unmatched and undeterred spirit. I see strength and courage and a renewed boldness to face the future unafraid. Unafraid. That's unique to you, by the way. That doesn't happen in every church. I'd love for it to be so. It is not. I see seed planters here. You'll hear me talk a lot about seeds over these next few years, because I see seed planters who are planting seeds of hope. Hope in the children you've just heard. Back to the start with baby Milo. Where is baby Milo? Back in the back. You're seed planters for a future that's not our own. Seeds that will bear fruit that we may never see. We may never see. You have been faithfully patient, or patiently faithful, whichever way you want to say that. You have been patiently faithful. You know that morning does come. You know that there's a new day dawning. You know that good things come to those who wait, and who wait faithfully and patiently. You know that God is great, and God's steadfast love endures forever, just as you heard read. And it's not just for today. God's steadfast love endures forever. Not today, not tomorrow, not next week, not for the next month, but forever. And friends, y'all, forever is a really, really long time. Forever is forever. That's a level of faithfulness and a love that is virtually impossible for mere mortals to fully grasp. Yet here you are. Here you are. All you have needed, God has provided. Not just some, but all you have needed, God has provided. Even when you had doubts, God provided. It hasn't all been easy. I don't have to tell you that. But there's an and here. It hasn't all been easy, and, not a but, and God takes the impossible and makes it possible. You're living proof. You're living proof. 80 years here. Some of you have been here 37, 40. I mean, I've heard all kinds of numbers already this morning. Now, 11 years ago, let me remind you, 11 years ago, your financial picture looked impossible. Looked impossible. And look at you now. Trying to figure out, well, who do we pay first? What do we do now? Looked impossible. But look at you now. You thought you might raise enough money to reduce a little debt. And you did that and a lot more, like another building. Look at you now. You thought you might be able to create ways to help your community. All the things you are doing now to help your community. Look at you now. When we get an indication that God is leading us in a different direction, the church has no trouble following. People talk about thy will be done as a prayer that never fails. It fails all the time when our free will clashes with God's. But when everyone involved in something says, thy will be done, not my own, and we get out of God's way, God really does have free reign, and it opens up the landscape for God to do whatever God wants. Asbury lives that out every day. Those are not my words. Those are your pastor's words. That's what your pastor says about you out there to the world. Describing you and the ways you respond to the Spirit of the living God. In the face of some daunting experiences, you have stood firm and you've rested on the words of the hymn writer. All I have needed, thy hand has provided. Strength for today, bright hope for tomorrow. Nothing was going to stop you. Remember that worldwide pandemic? Seemed like a million years ago, doesn't it? Racial and political turmoil, that is just yesterday. Unparalleled mental and health challenges that plague our communities, that wouldn't stop you. Disaffiliation of churches, that wasn't going to stop you. Denominational chaos, nothing was going to stop you. You are unstoppable. You are unstoppable. Now, I know your pastor is a fantastic leader. She is an amazing leader. But it has taken you, faithful lay people, to stand strong and firm, knowing that God is great and that God is faithful. Pastor's done her part, but you have done amazing work. More than enough. Because any one of these things would have derailed any church anywhere. But not you. But not you. Because you know. You know God's faithfulness is great. And that morning by morning, new mercies you're going to see. And all you've needed, God's provided. You know that. You also know you probably have everything you need right here, right now, and then some. Now, I know what some of you might be thinking, oh, but Bishop, there's just so much more. There's so much more happening in the world today. It's upside down. Some of this hasn't changed. So much continues to happen every single day, and that is absolutely true. Absolutely true. The ledger isn't adding up, and that is true. But you can't rest on what you've done. Now you've done all these great things, and all this other stuff keeps happening in the world, and now you've got to decide to square your shoulders to the future and keep moving forward right now, today. A friend I was with just this past week, I was at the Council of Bishops meeting, gathering of bishops from all over the world, and we had a great teacher. If you were at annual conference this year, you might have heard Dr. Paul Chilcote speak. And he reminded us, I didn't know this, I know I'm supposed to know these kind of things, but I didn't know this, that one of Wesley's favorite words that he used over and over, John Wesley, founder of Methodism, one of his favorite words was now. Now. Simple, three letters, now. He used it to express urgency and importance and to get our attention. That now reminds us that God sustains us right now, today, when things seem impossible. When God just works that way. And Wesley reminded us that now is the moment, now is the time. I don't want to squander this opportunity. You have everything you need, everybody you need right now in this room. When you don't know what to do, when we've got more than we know in front of us, and we've forgotten a whole lot more than we now even know, we have everything we need right now. I was sharing with Lindsay a story that my husband and I were in a church when we were serving in Louisiana, and we walked into a sanctuary, a very unconventional sanctuary, and the pastor stood up before everybody and said, you know those nursery workers we've been praying for? You need to stop praying today. Our prayers have been answered. And you saw this, you know, you heard this audible gasp, and these people just turned around and looked at each other like, what do you mean? We still need nursery workers. He said, no. Our prayers have been answered. All our nursery workers are right here, right now in this room. We can stop praying. And you could see people like, oh, what, me? You know, surely you're talking about that. But that's the kind of faithfulness I think we have. Everything we need is right here, right now. In God's abundant love for us, we do have strength for today, bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings are ours, 10,000s besides, says that hymn. In the midst of chaos in the world, some we can't control and some that we create ourselves, in the midst of all that, God is still at work. God is still using all of the messiness that we bring. God is still at work. And in these in-between times when what's in front of us looks like nothing that's behind us, we learn each and every single day that there is, in fact, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. When we're losing strength and hope is not so bright, we borrow it from one another. We borrow it from one another. We become strength and hope for someone else. So I'm just asking, if you can imagine yourself to continue to model every day what it looks like to bring strength and hope for one another, especially when the world is in chaos, that you might be strengthened by what God is doing in and among you. I am strengthened and amazed and in awe at what God is doing in and among you. As I said, you have great leaders. Great clergy leaders, lay leaders, young leaders, older leaders. I want you to remember the children that sang. I want you to remember the children whose blessing I received. Oh my gosh, touched my heart. The gift to Lydia Patterson Institute, a group of children you will never meet. And you've just contributed $704. So a child on the border from El Paso to Juarez who would never have been able to go to school now has an opportunity to go to school. You are changing people's lives that you may never meet. That's what it means to count on God's great faithfulness. So I want you to listen for the children. Listen for the children. Listen to one another. Everybody in this room and in your community has a voice that needs to be heard. They have a contribution to make. to the goodness of God and what God is doing in this part of the state of Texas and the Texas Annual Conference. So I challenge you to use all of your resources, fiscal resources, human resources, in ways that will lead to a future that is thriving, a future that's going to change the people and the hearts and minds. You may never turn them into United Methodists. That's not the point. But you will turn them into faithful followers of Jesus wherever they are. If you're clear about who you are, if you're clear about your purpose, if you're a witness for the gospel of Jesus Christ in every place that you go, play, work, every place, if in fact that you could see the world as fully abundant, not what you don't have. Churches are famous for that. Oh, but we don't have enough money. We don't have enough room. We don't have enough workers. You have everything you need. Abundance, abundance. And in all things that you will hold the value of kinship, of being with people, being at table with people as a high value. And most importantly, that you will experience great joy just by being in the presence of one another and in the presence of God. Friends, what you do today is not for yourselves, but it's for future generations. You know, I love the Native American understanding that the decisions that we make today will make an impact 7 generations into the future. So we see a couple of babies here. So let me remind you, it's your babies, children, their children, their children, their children, their children, their children, their children. 7 generations. That is why we are here. That is why we are here. So seize the moment. Keep choosing to do a new thing, to be a renewed people, to be faithful to what God is asking of you. Just sing these old songs with a renewed sense of passion, of hope and love, understanding of God's great faithfulness. Because you know, I know, you see today what you couldn't see years ago, months ago, maybe even yesterday, because you're experiencing here firsthand the surprises of the Spirit at every turn. And finally, Asbury United Methodist Church, I have something to say to you. Most important 2 words I think I can cobble together today. And that is to say, thank you. Thank you. If you hear nothing else I say today, and remember, I want you to remember those 2 words. Thank you. Thank you for reclaiming your identity, your place in this community. Thank you for being undeterred and resolute. Thank you for your commitment to reimagine a spirit of United Methodism in this community that has not ever been seen or heard. Thank you for building a church, not for yourselves, but for your children and their children and their children and their children. It's exciting. It's exciting, y'all, to see how you are recapturing the spirit of the movement of God and how you're doing that together. And what you're doing day in and day out is nothing short of courageous. See, I told you this was going to be a pep talk and a pep rally. What you do day in, day out is nothing short of courageous. With faithful followers of Jesus like you, I am absolutely certain that your best days are yet ahead. Your best days are yet ahead. And the seeds you plant today will flourish for years to come. You're creating spaces and places where the little ones today will bring their grandchildren someday and enjoy the splendor of what seeds you planted. So I invite you to keep listening to the deepest yearning of the people around you, not just in this building, but out in the community. And I want to just tell you that you don't have to have all the answers. You do not have to have it all figured out. All you have to do is be faithful and take the next faithful step. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, I really pray that you will continue to
keep guiding this great church to a new future that's filled with hope and promise and new possibilities that we have not even begun to dream of yet. And that you keep planting these seeds that will flourish in the lives of this community, that will change the trajectory for generations to come. You have this amazing wide open door and wide open windows to revive and renew and reinvigorate and reimagine a new future for Asbury United Methodist Church and for this entire community. A future that will birth a renewed sense of unity in the church, in the conference, and the United Methodist Church. But probably my greatest prayer is that you will set a table that is large enough for everyone, leaving room for those with differing thoughts and opinions and interpretations. You see, the table for me is not just a metaphor, you know, the communion table, but it is a beautiful example of what I believe the kingdom of God and congregations like this can create for the communities in which we get to serve, that we get to set this giant table where all are invited to come and to celebrate and to share at the table. You see, at God's table, there is no hierarchy. Everybody comes to the table as equals. That's what our churches ought to be, is this giant table of place, a place where people come as equals, that no matter where you are or where you come from, rich, poor, black, white, Asian, brown, Democrat, or Republican, whether you have it all figured out or you're still broken to pieces and trying to figure it out, that the table of grace has a place for everyone. So continue to use your energy to make something of this moment, something holy and sacred that's a catalyst for change. And I say this every chance I get, everywhere I go. When you base every decision you make on love, you will never go wrong. When you make every decision based on love, you will never go wrong. We don't have to understand or agree. We simply must love. So continue to embody what it means to be the church. Continue to sing of God's great faithfulness. And with grit and determination and the guidance of the Holy Spirit, people in this community will hear you singing. They will see you. They will taste you. They will smell you coming. And they'll wonder, what in the world is happening over there at that church in corner of Pasadena? So thank you. Thank you for being the church. Thank you for continuing to sing a new song. We're going to sing that chorus one more time, and I'm going to ask you to stand as we sing.
A chance to lift our voices, continuing in song and celebration here one more time. I'm going to find this last song, which is one of our favorites. It's called I Thank God, and I just encourage you, want to remind you that this is, when we sing together, this is a chance for us to lift praises up to the Lord. There's no right or wrong way to do that. So however you feel led to worship this morning, we encourage you to do that. Let's sing together. Can't with the bottom slowly drifting.
change my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior. Sano mi corazón.
And God said amen, I think. Yeah, yeah. Hey, y'all take a seat just a second because I have one last thing to celebrate with you today. Stephen, would you come forward? Stephen has
been worshiping with us for some time. He met the Lord in the United Methodist Church years ago, moved
to our area, found his way to Asbury, and we are excited to have him join the church today. One of his friends in the congregation is Mary. Mary is one of our shepherds here at Asbury, and she is going to be your shepherd, Stephen. And so I know you know about our shepherd ministry, and she kind of represents our congregation today as she is here with you. So I'm going to ask you the question that is asked of every person when they join the church, and that is this. Do you believe in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? You put all of your trust in his grace, and do you promise to serve him here at Asbury with your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness?
I do.
Congregation, we have a commitment that we make back to him. Will you join with me? We will support him as a part of our body of Christ. We will pray for him, encourage his faith, and walk alongside him as brothers and sisters in Christ. We will continue to seek opportunities to worship regularly, grow in our faith, serve together, and share the good news of Jesus, making disciples in his name. Will you join me in welcoming Stephen into our congregation today? If y'all can join me as service closes out in the main hall so folks can greet you. All right, thank you so much. A few things that I want to announce and just make sure you know about. We have a lot going on, as you know, in the month of November. Out in the main hall, you can purchase a new church history book, a photo album of sorts that we put together for our 80th celebration, and that's out in the main hall for $10. Also, we now have new Asbury t-shirts and hoodies and onesies even and hats and all kinds of things, and you can find out about how you can purchase that on our church website out in the main hall as well, or click that QR code. The directories are here and they're ready. So if you took a picture for our church directory, then your free copy is out in the main hall, and we'd love to get that in your hands today. Next Sunday, are you going to show up here at 11 o'clock?
No,
because you're going to show up here at? Thank you so much for our one worship service. We don't often get to worship all together as a congregation. We're going to do that next week. And so be here at 10 next week, not 11. And then we're going to have a potluck afterwards. You'll see at the bottom here, according to your last name, what item you're supposed to bring. And I just really need all of the S's to show up next week, okay? Okay, so I look forward to worshiping with you next week. We're going to have games and prizes, lots of fun together. You know our annual Thanksgiving Blessings ministry, and if you could help grab some canned food and the rest of the items, we've actually it was incredible, but someone donated all of the turkeys for all of our boxes, which is just such a gift, yes. So now we just need to fill it in with all of the stuffing and all that kind of stuff. And so if you'd like to find out what items we need and be bringing those over the next couple weeks, we're going to be, packing out this sanctuary on the 18th in the evening to pack those boxes. We turn the music up, we go around and fill the boxes. It's so much fun. I hope you'll be here for that too. You can order Christmas poinsettias if you like, if in honor and memory of someone. They are put up on the chancel area during Christmas, and then after the Christmas Eve service, you can take it home with you. Also, our 20-something small group accompanied is meeting again this Wednesday at 6:30 at Mama Mia's, and they would love to have you join. Anybody? Not this Wednesday, next Wednesday. Thank you so much, Jesse. And so I'm giving you advance notice, okay? Not this week, but next. And our youth group's bonfire and s'mores night is tonight at 6 o'clock. So if you are between 6th and 12th grade and would like to come up here for the annual bonfire they do every November, they'd love to have you. They're going to have so much fun. We have prayer partners. They're going to be here. If you would like to have someone pray with you today, that's what they're here for. I'm going to invite you to stand as we receive the benediction today, Bishop.
As you prepare to go from this place, go knowing that God is faithful and will provide everything you need and then some, and will surprise even you at the bounty of God's blessings upon you and your lives. So as you go forth, go now in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Praise when I'm sure, and praise when I'm doubting. I'll praise without number, and praise when surrounded. 'Cause praise is the water my enemies drown in.
As long as I'm breathing,
I praise 'cause I know you're still in control. 'Cause my praise is a weapon, it's more than a sound. My praise is a shout, woo, that brings Jericho down.
As long as I'm breathing,
could I keep